So, who cares? Why not do your own thing and let them say what they want?
What's up, guys? Welcome to another Get Ready With Me. And this time, I actually have topics to talk about, things that I want to get off my chest and just randomly ramble about while I do makeup. And hopefully I can do so semi-coherently so this becomes a good video and not just a clusterfuck. Anyway, this is probably like the worst I can possibly look. I'm pale, I have bad skin because when I take a lot of days off, I neglect my skincare routine, which I should not do. If you guys start seeing me getting like shitty ass skin that when you touch it, it's really reddening and stuff, be like, bitch, stop neglecting your skincare routine for Assassin's Creed Origins. Thank you. But anyway, today what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be doing like this really cool elf look. And when I say really cool, it's probably gonna be shit because when I do these Get Ready With Me's, it's always me just kind of like improvising with something that I have in my head, like an idea. I don't look anything up or follow any tutorial. I'm basically just winging it. And I have a cool idea for like an icy elf that I want to do today, and I just want to take a few pictures for Patreon and for Instagram and stuff. I'm not going to talk too much about what I'm doing because I'm going to be just rambling about topics. So if you happen to be a 20%er, one of my female viewers, hi guys, by the way, I love you, just post any question in the comments and I'll let you know what product, what technique, or whatever you want to know about. I am an open book and a tabula rasa of a face right now. Without further ado, let's get some fucking makeup on this crazy mug. I'm going to put some dry shampoo in my hair and then put it up, because I want the dry shampoo to fully absorb all of the grease. I know this is a lot, but it's literally been like 3 days since I've showered. The first thing I want to talk about is the Liam Neeson thing. So the thing that where everyone's calling him a racist now because he said some shit. If you guys haven't seen the clip, the full clip, and not just someone calling him a racist, please look it up. Right now, I will wait, as in you can pause me freely because I am at your discretion. Oh yes. I really don't like the way people are handling it, and it's not atypical of how everyone always handles everything, especially in the vocal majority, like on Twitter and stuff, where everyone just wants to paint a hate mob and do like these end XYZ person things. These campaigns to end people's careers because they fuck up or say something that they don't like. Oh, that is way too tight. It makes my head look crazy. Gotta still look cute while I'm doing the makeup. I'm a pixie. Oh, by the way, these ears are gonna be the ears that I use. These are my headphones that I use at my gaming PC for streaming and for playing PC games. And this is the wrong side. I'm gonna be wearing these and then I'm gonna put the hair on either sides of them. And I actually have my super green extensions that I curled yesterday and I'm gonna brush these out and it's gonna be very ethereal, hopefully, if I can get things right. This is Swan, right? Yeah, this is my light shit. So I usually do 3 spurts of the light shit and then 1 spurt of the normal dark shit. Let me know if my titties pop out. I haven't worn a bra since I've gone pale. It's really weird. Okay, I don't think it's racist. I think it is a reactionary response to extreme trauma, i.e. his friend being raped and him not knowing how to deal with it rationally. So he's having like an extreme irrational emotional response. And it's kind of like peaking his evolutionary biology. Like, our tribalism is ingrained in our biology through evolution. When people look different from us, or when people are part of a group that is unknown to us, they are more likely to be dangerous. This is widely useless today because people mix races and relationships and culture, and other cultures aren't necessarily dangerous to ours or to us, especially in a civilized society where we have cops and military and stuff like that. This looks terrible, I know. It looks like a fucking mask. I don't know if I can talk about like deeper topics like this coherently while doing makeup. We're gonna try though. We are gonna try. So let me know what you think, and if you want me to expound on anything that I said here, just feel free to ask in the comments. If it's about makeup or if it's about philosophy, I'm a complete open book. So on top of that, our tribalism, he's also experiencing a like, I need to find this person, bring them to justice, and if I can't find that specific person that raped my friend, I'm going to blame something. And the one characteristic that that person has that sets him apart is the fact that he's black. His illogical, crazy, emotional, very young, because he said it was 40 years ago, so he's gotta be like 20 and under or something, right? Brain is like computing this completely wrong. I'm not defending him in any way. I feel like it's so stupid that I have to say this, because obviously I don't defend someone going out and trying to provoke someone into getting killed. I'm pulling this down onto my chest because the foundation isn't perfectly matched, and I also want to be as lily white as possible, and also lower the possibility that I just touch myself and turn red. The photo shoot that I'm gonna be doing is gonna be from like boobs up or like from waist up. So we're gonna do a little bit of my shoulders and my chest as well, just to be as evenly white as possible, to feign like I have the skin of like Marilyn Monroe or something. I almost said Marilyn Manson. Well, that too, I guess. But it's so silly to me that people are just like freaking out and like crying racism. Like if he was actually like a harmful racist that was like part of the alt-right white nationalist movement or something, he wouldn't be vocal about it. He wouldn't talk about it like it was a mistake. He wouldn't talk about it like it was a dark part of his life. So it's crazy. It's just absolutely crazy to me that someone hears that story and first of all is so disassociated from humanity that they can't see themselves or someone else that they love becoming that exact way through extreme trauma. All they hear is a black guy and they think like, oh my god, now Liam Neeson has forever been racist, even though he's worked with a lot of black people and probably has black friends and probably even fucked a black chick or dude or two. Really doesn't make any sense. And then the second issue that I have with this, that I take with this on a deep level, Cetaphil to wipe off my hands. Why do we care so much if people are racist? As long as they're obeying the law, then being racist is just another bad or stupid opinion akin to a lot of things. Like, I don't know, what people would assume is like global warming isn't real. I am not 100% convinced either way. You can hate on me for that, it's just I haven't invested my time into it and both sides seem to make sense. But to me, it just really doesn't make any sense to care so much if someone has the opinion that they don't like people because of their skin color. First of all, it just makes them stupid. It doesn't make them dangerous. There's a difference between dangerous racists and people who are just racist, like old grandmas or something, who are still stuck in their ways and just have like silent things that they say under their breaths. I'm not saying that you should like those people, because obviously that's an obnoxious trait to have. For me, it's more obnoxious because it's fucking stupid. You can't judge anyone just by their skin color or any other superficial trait like that. So for me, racism is just an illogical position. And caring about preserving like the white race or white skin or whatever, obviously I fucking don't even like my white skin. I would prefer it to be a little bit darker, but I do understand people who just aren't as attracted to it or don't like the culture. I am part of the latter where I don't like the culture. But as I stated before, every color partakes in every culture. So for me, it's not black culture, it would rather be hip hop culture. And I get along just as poorly with a white person or a Mexican person who's super into hip hop culture and that's like a lot of their being, makes up a lot of who they are as a person with their personality, as I would with a black person. And I would get along just as well with a black nerd or a black metalhead as I would with a white one. I think people really just quickly jump to racism. They really quickly jump to this hate mob, like end everyone, end this guy's career. And I personally don't understand any of that and can't get on board with that. Like, first of all, why do you wanna be angry all the time? Second of all, every single person, like what Terry Crews says, and I 100% agree with him on this, every single person has the propensity and the capacity to do quote unquote evil and quote unquote good. It all depends on how they react to the circumstances, their mental chemistry, and how sound of mind they are at the time. And a few other aspects. Wow, I'm like white as fuck right now. I have to turn this down. So white, I have to turn down my camera ISO. Wow. So the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my big brush and I'm gonna put some of the translucent vagina powder all over it. All over my face, not the brush, well also the brush too. I think what Liam Neeson said was completely candid. I think it was important for us to talk about these kinds of mental, basically shortcomings that we can fall into because of trauma. I think it's important to talk about things that are part of the human condition, but aren't necessarily the nicest, sweetest things. And I think the biggest issue with political correctness and the biggest issue with people trying to be nice all the time when they don't feel like being nice is that we don't know what the truth is. We don't know who people really are. Would you really rather Liam Neeson, let's say he is super fucking racist, would you really rather that he doesn't ever tell you that? That he discludes that from every single talk he has with you so that you grow a friendship with this person that you don't know is a horrible human being in your eyes? If you just knew the person better, why do you want everyone to be artificial? Not only does it make for really poor, boring, fucking bland media and art, but it's not authentic. And for me, I prefer authenticity and the right to free speech and upholding that much more than just being nice. And if I get to know someone, I want them to be honest with me just like I would give them that same courtesy. I don't want to like someone on artificial grounds. And another thing I see that's really weird is a lot of people, like, just cannot be friends with someone who has different views to them. Like, I have some really ridiculous libtard friends. I would actually consider my parents to be pretty libtard. My best friends here in Vegas are, like, huge SJWs. But I would consider them to be among, like, my best friends. Even though some things that they say annoy me and some positions that they take annoy me, it's more important for me to talk those out or to hear varying opinions and be involved with the lifestyle of varying opinions so that I can understand them better. Because one thing that a lot of people don't understand when they just call racism, or even on the other side, when they just call stupid fucking SJW libtard bitch or whatever. I don't know why I added bitch. The circumstance that you're in and the opinions that you hold are often byproducts, just coping mechanisms of either having a poor upbringing or having some kind of trauma. Humans are extremely adaptable creatures. Oh, I forgot to do my under eye. I'm gonna forget a lot of things here because I'm just talking up a storm and not even thinking about the makeup. But the fact that they can adapt so well is also the reason why they can do some fucking nasty shit in response to some terrible stuff that's happened to them. For instance, like Liam Neeson looking to go beat up a black dude or kill a black dude because his good friend was raped by a black dude. Now, can I see myself getting in that kind of mindset? Not from that particular circumstance, but I can see myself looking for someone to blame and something to cling onto, some kind of hate outlet, you know? And that's what he was doing. When I was younger, and I told you guys about this before, I had a lot of like black girlfriends and stuff because I lived in an area that was close to like kind of an inner city-ish area. And if you look at all of, like, my school pictures from when I was younger, it's always, like, mostly minorities. The color palette of my friends, I'm contouring my nose, by the way, which looks really bad. Oh, fuck, I used the wrong color. Okay, we're gonna over-contour it, and then we're gonna try to blend it out. So, like, I was exposed at a young age to a lot of different colors of people from a lot of different backgrounds, like Ethiopian, and I was friends with all these people. And then when I got into middle school, I was treated really, really, really poorly by like so many black girls. Black girls wanted to jump me, black girls just randomly hated me, and even though I had this opinion where like, oh my god, I wanted to be black when I was like in elementary school. I was like, why don't I have this really fucking awesome afro hair, which, oh, I love that thick, coarse hair. I've always wanted to have one of those like fucking natural afros. So pretty. I hated that my hair was lifeless and thin and didn't have any body, and I also felt really weird being like one of the only white kids. So I wanted to have some kind of ethnic background. Like, I was jealous of the Heinz 57s. And I'm gonna be contouring a little bit more because I'm doing like an SFX type look. It's not SFX, but you know what I mean. Like, not an everyday look. Like, I'm trying to go for kind of like an ethereal, elfy bitch. And so I went from admiring and even being jealous of these girls to not only fearing, but also kind of having this preconceived notion of like, oh, I see a black girl. Is she gonna wanna fight me? Is she gonna hate me? And that fear can turn into something like hatred, you know? It doesn't have to though. If you're more of a logical person and you realize the circumstances and you realize why they are hurting and why they don't like you and why they have preconceived notions about you, you can be more empathetic, and therefore you're never gonna fall into the trap of being racist irrationally for no reason because you had one trauma in your life. Or hating men, for instance, being a misandrist or being a misogynist because you had one or two or even 10 bad experiences with a man or a woman. And I think what everyone is lacking these days, everyone, is a little bit of like understanding where people are coming from. It doesn't matter if you would ever react that way. Everyone is just a fucking math problem, an equation away from making certain decisions. And I know this is like an anti-free will argument because I don't believe in like free will in the way that we describe it, where it's like, I choose holy and there's a God. You kind of have to believe in something like a higher being than us if you actually believe in free will. But anyway, I don't want to get into that. If you guys want me to do a video on that, I would probably want to research a little bit to use the right terms and stuff so I don't sound like a complete fucking asshat. This is really harsh contouring, so what I'm gonna do is kind of buff it out a little bit. I'm gonna buff out the shit. So, I don't know. Let me know what you think about the Liam Neeson thing. I mean, it's pretty shocking, obviously, but shocking things are, again, part of the human condition. And I think we should be able to talk about these things so that people don't feel so alone and then go down that rabbit hole. Like, imagine Liam Neeson with no support system, looking for someone to talk to, but he can't ever go to any normal person to talk about it because the normal person will just call him a racist instead of helping him through it, helping him get like a fucking psychologist or a psychiatrist or something. And then he just like turns to the alt-right because the alt-right is the only place where he feels fucking accepted, and it's no longer about whether or not he's racist. He's just in with this group because that's the only group where he can talk about this stuff. Not because he's actually a racist or because he actually wants to be radicalized or any fucking thing like that. I think it's important for us to be able to understand these things for what they are and not place stupid arbitrary labels on them. It's like, oh my fucking God, you guys, calm the fuck down. I don't know if I've become too apathetic or not to everything, but I really feel like it's not an unhealthy apathy. It's like me understanding a little bit better the human condition and not pretending like we're supposed to be some immaculate godlike beings. It's like, in place of a god now, because most of us are atheists or something similar, believers who don't actually follow anything. Highlight of time. Oh yeah, baby. So the next thing I wanted to talk about is the Gillette ad thing. I know I'm super late and I actually thought about making an actual video, but then I was like, nah, whatever, fuck it. Everyone's already done it to death. Even though I do feel like I can give a kind of a both sides perspective on it, like I always do. I'm gonna contour my lip. Oh, you know what I was gonna do? That's right. I was gonna white out my lips. I'm gonna do like an intense smoky eye. And then I'm gonna do like white it out. Kind of, you'll see. It's like bitten lips. It seems like everyone was having a really polarized reaction. People were either extremely bent out of shape or they didn't care at all and they were like, why do people care? And I personally don't think, like, the funniest reactions to me were the ones that are like, wow, Gillette really fucked themselves now. They didn't know they were gonna be so fucked. How could they not have known? I personally believe, and I don't think anyone has shared this sentiment with me, but I think they knew that outrage causes first a drop, then a spike in like, what's the word? Like the market value, the stocks. And I think what they wanted was to rile people up, and I think they do have the opinion that, like, all publicity is good publicity. Because there's no way that they made something for majority male consumers that is basically just, like, telling men that they need to do better. Obviously, there are men that do need to do better, but all you have to do to understand why people are so bent out of shape is see how frequent it is for people to hate on white people and white men specifically in this day and age. It's like rampant. Like, it's literally okay to say kill all men or like, oh, you white cis male, and completely discredit anything that a white cis male does. And then the majority of these white cis men are like lower middle class or worse, and they aren't well off, and they aren't like holding positions. So they are feeling super disenfranchised and angry and just sick of it altogether. And then another way for you to put yourself in their shoes is to just think about, imagine if that was a video talking about, oh, us black men can do better. That would be so ridiculously bad. But everything is just permitted when it comes to white men or men in general. Being treated like shit as a way to kind of achieve equality these days, because black men and women and, you know, all these intersectional things have been so oppressed for so long. Imagine the fix for that is just being mean to the descendants of the oppressors. It's really, it doesn't make any sense. They're not gonna take kindly to it. They're not gonna want to, like, be allies or whatever unless they have some kind of ulterior motive, because it's so against them. Or then we could do, like, a woman version. And I was actually gonna do a skit to woman version. I thought that would be really fun. So I can understand both sides. I'm not personally outraged or super offended by it. It's pretty par for the course these days. I made a joke in the comment section, like, the first day that it came out. I was like, I'm so glad I switched to Dollar Shave Club or something like that. It was probably just like Dollar Shave Club, because I do use Dollar Shave Club. They don't sponsor me, but they used to send me mysteriously free product. It was really weird. Like, they never contacted me. I was just getting free product, and I don't know, maybe one of my viewers bought it for me, but I've been using their stuff ever since. So that marketing tool did work. I want it to feel like I'm an icy blue-green elf. But it's kind of like my hair color and everything is like a byproduct of the cold. I don't think it's ever going to go over well with anyone. It's never gonna make anyone change or do better if there is a necessity to do better anyway, because someone basically talks shit to them and says, dude, you need to do better. That kind of like extreme tough love that probably doesn't apply to like 99.9% of the consumers of Gillette, it's only gonna make people become defensive. This is like relationship 101. You can't just come up to your significant other or your kid and just be like, all you ever do is blah, 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 blah. Like, the first thing they tell you to do in like family counseling or family therapy or whatever is to talk about how you feel. Like, I feel like you're doing this and that bullshit, because it's less confrontational and you're gonna get better results that way. So if they actually wanted results, first of all, most men aren't these terrible misogynistic creatures. Second of all, it clearly has a political agenda by using people like Anna Kasparian and talking about the Me Too movement. And third of all, you really think that anyone who's actually out there raping and pillaging and doing actually bad male things, using actual male traits in toxic ways, is gonna be like, oh, okay, that's how I'm supposed to act? No, they're not. The good men are just gonna get defensive and angry and saddened by it. Stop buying the products. But I think maybe they actually want that, like, soy boy type demographic to start buying their products, because that's the new generation. My eyes have been hurting a lot lately. Okay, so another thing I want to do is I want to put it on my cheeks just a little bit. So I got that pigment. Oh my god, this might be a lot. This is actually kind of a practice to my Cortana cosplay I'm going to be doing. I'm going to just, like, roll up my hair. So I'm going to be doing one of these for that, too. But I'm just going to, like, roll up my hair to make it short instead of wearing the wig, because the wig, I don't like cheap wigs. I fucking hate cheap wigs. I think I've conquered this format in terms of being able to speak while I'm doing this. It's just that my ability to speak concisely kind of starts lacking. If there's anyone else that you know that does like deeper talks while they do their makeup, I would love to know who. I know the makeup industry, especially on YouTube though, is pretty immense. And therefore it's pretty saturated, and therefore a lot of people have to really fight to make their own. So I think it's kind of like too risky for people to talk about stuff like this. Maybe there's a super leftist version of me or something out there. That would be cool. I would watch that. I hate that this isn't very pigmented. The peach palette, I feel like it might be a dupe or something. Cause it's really like not, it's my favorite, but it's like really not pigmented. Like, I gotta really push in there. Fuck! I got all over my, god damn it. It just comes off if I brush it lightly. So from here on out, I think I'm gonna do a time lapse and I'm gonna start listening to YouTube videos. So, cause this is like the part where it's actually kind of hard. I'll leave the camera on and it'll be like a little time lapse. So you guys can actually watch what I do and stuff. And if there's any time where you want any info on what I do, please do let me know. Time lapse commence!
Thank you.
right, guys, I'm pretty much done. I'm going to go ahead and get naked, move the camera over there, and then I'll insert a little montage after I snap my fingers in a second and do my little outro. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like the video and subscribe if you enjoyed. I think if I continue to do this kind of series, I'm going to do the basics while I talk to you guys, and then I'll do the artistic stuff in a time-lapse fashion. And then to keep you guys here, or at least keep you guys skipping to the end, I'll do a sexy little montage at the end of the final result so you can see the before and the after. All right, cue montage.